This is Mike Helm with another time-lapse video for the book bus. This is spread number 6. After I released the last couple of these time-lapse videos, I received requests for additional commentary, so here it is. In this part of the story, Tilly the truck is in what I suppose could be called authentic depression, feeling neglected and alone, no longer useful, like that part of her life is over. So portraying her in this dark barn with light peeking in from the outside through the window and the cracks in the walls seemed one way to illustrate that. This one offered the chance to represent more wood grain, which I loved doing during this project. The garden tools on the right side of the image were a leftover from an early illustration I'd made for spread number 3 before we had final dimensions for the book. By the time we got those, I had made, I think, 3 images, and it turned out that the format I'd worked in wouldn't fit, so I had to start over. I didn't mind. I'm not certain where I got the notion to use graphite pencils on top of the watercolor. Possibly from Maurice Sendak's Where the Wild Things Are, which was a favorite when I was a lad. Those illustrations looked to me like pen and ink on top of watercolor, and I think I tried that at the start. But early in our discussions for this book, Melanie had told me that she was after a soft look, so this is where we ended up. This image, for better or worse, owes a great debt to Andrew Wyeth. I have long admired his painting, especially his depictions of empty rooms and common things, how he conveyed such beauty and detail in scenes otherwise ordinary and nondescript. If you're not familiar with his work, I commend it to your eye, and you're welcome. Thank you for watching. I appreciate the interest in these illustrations, and I'm so glad to be able to share these time-lapse videos with you. On behalf of Schiffer Books, Melanie Moore, Brian Wray, and yours truly, Mike Helm, I wish you well and thank you for your kind attention.